Welcome to my channel for Tangy Lines. My name is Mildred Lee and I have to grab it first. Oh, I'm gonna pee in my pants. Oh gosh. Oh. I got this one. I got also this one too. Oh, I'm sitting on something that I'm not supposed to sit on. Gosh. This one, I think that's it. Okay, I think that's it. I'm not sure. What was it? I think that's it, yes. So, I have also another, how do you say, envelope that I'm going to show you later because my washi tape keeps running away. I mean, it's really bad washi tape. Sorry, I need to tape this down in order to show it to you. Let's see. Okay. And another piece. I'm sorry, I really have to do this. So, I have to tape it down. Okay. I'm going to show you why I have to tape it down. Okay? Please, have patience. So, I got this one. B and Envara. In the olden days. No, not in the olden days. Joking. When you watch TV, you grab the TV guide, or you don't have to. You don't need the TV guide. Our TV has a lot of channels, and one of those channels it's called BNN Vara. BNN Vara. Some years ago, it was led by Bart de Graaf. Bart de Graaf was a young boy, an adolescent. But he had this sickness that he couldn't grow. He stayed small. But he was not a midget. I think there was something with his organ. I don't know which kind of organ it. But eventually he died of this disease. I guess it was incurable if there was no organ to... how do you say it? It was not a free organ for him to transplant. Because I guess a lot of people said, I want to keep my own organ. I'm not going to give it to you for free or at all. So I think that's the way he died. But his channel that he started after he died, before he died, it was well kept, organized. But after he died, everyone was in shambles. And his channel was actually dying. And... They asked the people, would you please sponsor us in the shape of or form of buying a subscription? And I said, of course, I said yes. So he asked them, I think like 10, was it 10 euros or 10 guilders? I think 10 euros then. And still to this day, I keep on subscribing them. I mean, it's just minimum 10 euros. So then, like every year, they give you something. And each year is different. So I'm not sure if it's that. I know that the last time that they want to send you something. And they ask you, like, if you still want, do you want it? Oh, I cannot open it. Wait, I'm going to lay it down because of these two packages. The reason why I want to open it neatly, I want to repurpose that. Reuse it. Because I don't have this kind of envelopes. Oh my god. Why? This double-sided tape is so... so tight. Oh gosh. What kind of good quality double-sided tape is this? Oh my god. Oh, I'm tired. I'm tired, even though I've had just lunch. My sandwich and soup. Oh my god. Oh god. A little bit. Oh God. All right. Oh my God. And it's not even open correct. Okay, now it's open. So I wonder what this is. They asked me some time ago, would you like to have it? And I said, yes, of course, but I don't think they had a lot of it. So it has to be like some kind of lottery. I don't think one can win it. I think some people can win it. So let's see. Oh, that was the back. I'm sorry. This is the back of it. Be an Enfara, make Holland great again. Oh gosh. So this is a tile, a Dutch tile, when they always do like a picture of something. I'm gonna show it to you. If I can grab it. Can I grab it? No, it's gone. It fell under the table. I cannot grab it. So this tile says, don't think about the last sheet. Who comes after me, he will manage himself. So don't think about the last sheet. That means, I think it means the toilet paper, the last sheet of toilet paper. Don't think about the last sheet of who comes after me. That person is able to save himself. Oh, I understand. Pull up your trousers and walk away. Maybe. So here, I understand. Yes, I know why he sent me this. This is a calendar, a birthday calendar. It says here, verjaardagskalender, birthday calendar, and it says here, whole or all Holland poops. So funny. Now I know why I wanted this. I love poop. I mean the poop emoji, of course, not poop. Oh, famous people are in here. So Bobby Eden, I don't know. Oh, wait, maybe. I'm gonna take the stand out. Oopsie, stand, go away. And then show it you like this. Oh, of course. And that's the first package and already 8 minutes. Okay, this is Bobby Eden. I'm gonna do it quickly. Bobby Eden she is not anymore. She used to be a porn star, a Dutch porn star. And I think she is also big in America. Well, in her time, now she isn't anymore. She doesn't do that anymore because now she finally has a baby with her husband. I don't know how old this baby is now. This one. Oh, it's not her birthday, but it's her picture on the toilet. It says, squatting is good at a public toilet to poop because they are not always clean. And Olga Commandeur is an old athlete and presenter. You know, TV presenter, but I don't know. I haven't seen her. Maybe because I don't watch too much TV. I watch TV for films, but not, you know. So this is Frank van der Lende. He's a radio presenter. This one is Eva Korman. She's also a radio presenter. And they will have a little story that they have to tell. So in March, who's that? Oh, I know who that is. When I see his mug face, I already know who that is. This one is Milan Knol. He's a YouTuber. And he was the first one, one of the first one that went on YouTube, on Dutch YouTube. And because he was one of the first, his younger brother, Enzo Knol, also follows him on his footsteps for YouTube. So I know that. So this one, oh, yes, of course. He's also famous in Rotterdam. I'm going to show his face, not his pants. Look at his smiling face. So this one is Ron Blau. He's a very great chef cook. Chef cook. I think he has one Michelin star, two Michelin star. I'm thinking about in his career over 20 years and 20 between 20 and 40 years. I think 30 years existence. I'm talking at the top of my head that he has achieved one or two Michelin stars. This one, I don't know who she is. Oh, of course I don't know who she is. She's Denise Spielman, Miss Netherlands 2020, last year's. Don't know who she is. Oh, I know who this is. She is Faya Laurens. And she has also a little bit of Suriname roots. This is a beautiful girl. She's now into good life, not good life, good wife, but good life, and how do you say it? Way of living with exercising. So I mean, fitness, and with fitness you have to eat properly. So that's what she does now. I have one. Her first book, I don't have her second book. The second book is about the same topics, but it's more like a cookbook. And she has now, recently has a third book. I don't know who this is. Veronica van Hoogdalem. She's a presenter. Oh, her birthday is here. 5th of August. Sometimes I miss the birthday of them. I don't know who this one is. He's a rapper, a Dutch rapper, and he's called Shaq. Shaq is, I think, a short man for Jack. It's not complete Jack, but it's a Dutch version of short man of Jack. Then you have the names. Ron Blau, the chef cook. Is on 7th September and Shaq is on 24th. Where's the other one? Oh, Milan Knol here. The YouTuber is on 13th of September. Oh, nice. This is so funny. People sitting on the toilet. And who's this? Emma Wortelboer. Oh, she's also a presenter of TV programs. Oh, this one. He is a real Suriname man. His name is Roué Verveer. He's a funny man. How do you say? A comedian. Yes, he's a comedian. He loves to play with words and the language, the Dutch language and the Suriname language. He's so funny. He says, in case you ever go to public toilet, first look if there's toilet paper. That it spares you a lot of embarrassment. I don't know how to translate that word. Spare it. Yeah, honey. Something embarrassment. What's the word? I don't know. I hope you understand what I mean. So it's true. It's true. Sometimes when you go outside and go to the stores, and some stores has toilet, you go to the toilet. Of course, you have to pay money. It used to be like 50 euro cents, but now they ask 1 euro for to go to the toilet. But normally, some of these toilet stalls have toilet paper, and some are out. So in case you go in one of the toilets, you open the door, you close the door after you've stepped inside, you do your thing, and then you realize, you try to pull the paper, the toilet paper, and you realize, oh my God, there's no toilet paper, and you've done your number one, and you're thinking, I have no tissue paper in my bag. Yeah, that's the embarrassment you get. I totally agree. So his birthday is on the 17th of November. I didn't know that. I know he has a beautiful wife. This man, I don't know who he is. He's Lars Boom. He's a bicyclist for sport, paid sport, they call it. So let's see. His birthday is on 30th of December, and is there another one? I don't know who that is. So, oh, it's nice. All Holland poops. Now I remember this one. I forgot it all about that. Okay, nice one. All right, so I'm gonna put it. Oh no, it's stuck. Double-sided tape. I'm gonna put you in my stand because I have to grab the box. The smaller box, of course. Smaller box. So, oh wait, stand, of course. Pull back. It says here, good oil brings good people together. Oh, Socrates. Okay, I like the illustration of this. So it's from Family Cretan Olive Oil. And the brand is called G. Casas. I saw this on Instagram. And actually, I don't know if you know, but I think I've mentioned it on YouTube. There is a necklace that is round. You can get it in silver or in gold or rose gold, but it's round. You peel it like an orange, but it's not broken when you peel it because they are folded nicely in a ball. So if you take it out, you can unravel it. When I saw this advertisement in Instagram, it was like, I want it. It's 20 euros, but I'll wait for it. So luckily I wait for it because then I think after 3 months or 4 months, it was one plus one. That means you buy one, you get the second for free. So I put my things in there, and what did they send me? One. I want to tell them, hey, I'm sorry, but you only sent me one instead of two. But the email came back. I cannot find them anymore on Instagram. They took my money and they ran. I was so mad. So I said to myself, I'm not going to try something else on Instagram. But this is something else. G. Casas is olive oil. They give you one sample, one tin of olive oil. They give it to you for free to sample. So I said to myself, yes, please. I love free stuff. You can see by the calendar, all Holland poops. So I love free stuff. So when you open this, let's see if I open it correctly. So this is the bag. Here it says you can scan with your camera, and there you get your free tin. And look at the beautiful illustration. You get one tin for free, and you can also put other people's address, but they have to give them consent. So you, even though you write their address, they can't receive it. They have to put their information themselves. Do you understand what I mean? I tried it to put my father's address on it, but it says no. He has to do it himself. So it says here, a can of G. Casas love special for you. And there is some text and about the family. And it's a beautiful box. I don't want to give it away. I like the illustration. I want to keep it for myself. Some boxes I keep for myself. Some boxes I'm going to give away by putting crafting stuff inside and send it to people. But oh, this is so beautiful, this. And the tin is unique. Normally you have the tin like this without the lid, but this tin, you need the can opener. And I just threw my can opener away because my son said, oh yes, your can opener is so nasty and crusty. I'm like, I didn't buy a new can opener, and now it's impossible to buy a new can opener. because I need to feel it and see it. I cannot order online. Some things when I buy, I need to see it and I need to feel it with my hands. I didn't know that it had a lid like this, because when you open it, it plops up. It has some kind of, I call it a neck, but it's not a neck. It's you open it up and something pops up, so you can easily, you know, get it out of the can and close it back. Because if you do with a can opener, it can go bad, they say. But real good quality olive oil, it cannot go bad. So I don't know why they say it can go bad. But I know, I understand, it's flat. You can, you know, kick it or drop it and all the olive oil can fall out. And with this special opener, you can open it, close it, and whatever you do, you won't spoil any olive oil. That's so smart. I love smart packaging. Japanese do that, and this is the first time I've seen some company do it also. Smart packaging. Really smart. Well, this is a sample. This is a sample. I don't know how, I haven't gone to the supermarket of Albert Heijn. My sons love to go to Albert Heijn. Albert Heijn is a bit high-end supermarket. I go just around the corner here, Dirk, and it's a low-end, cheap supermarket store. So I don't know if they sell it with the high-end supermarket. Like this, the same can, or is it a bigger one? I don't know. I see there's a green bottle on there.